Finally, on a lot of subscribers' requests, a complete step-by-step video to downgrade iOS 18 to 17 without losing data on a Windows PC using iTunes is here. An apology for the delay. The public beta is released now. I was waiting for it. Currently, you must be running the latest iOS 18 firmware on your iPhone or iPad, but probably are not satisfied with it. Facing a battery drainage issue, or some of the apps are malfunctioning, or whatever is causing a problem? Here I will show you how to downgrade iOS 18 public beta to iOS 17.5.1 without losing data using iTunes on a Windows computer. I will also show you how to restore iOS 18 backup to iOS 17.5.1. I will show you that I will have these apps back after the whole process, so watch the video till the end. As I mentioned, this is the process of going back to iOS 17 from iOS 18 public beta without losing data using iTunes on Windows. If you are a Mac user, I have already published a step-by-step tutorial on it. You can find the link in the description below. Let's start removing iOS 18 beta using iTunes on Windows and restore iOS 18 backup to 17 using iTunes. Before that, if you are new to my channel, hit the like and the subscribe button for more upcoming iOS 18 tutorials, which includes sideloading apps, jailbreaking, installing emulators, third-party app stores, and more. Now, first you need to arrange a few prerequisites for iOS downgrade process. You need to have an IPSW file and iTunes. Also, you need to turn off Find My iPhone and take a complete backup of your device using the iTunes. Let me share all of these one by one. For IPSW file, open the browser and go to the ipsw.me website. Select the device type you want to downgrade, iPhone or iPad. After that, select the model of your device. Once you click on your device, it will show you all the signed as well as unsigned versions available for your device. The green ones at the top are the signed ones. You can only downgrade to the signed versions, not to the unsigned ones in the red. Click on the green signed version, then on the blue button to download the IPSW file on your computer. You need this file to downgrade iOS 18 beta to iOS 17. Once it's done, install iTunes latest version on your PC. You can get that through the Microsoft Store. Guys, if you have already installed iTunes from the Apple website, you need to delete it as you may not be able to go back to iOS 17 from iOS 18 public beta. Also, you won't be able to restore iOS 18 backup to 17 using an older iTunes version. You can easily remove it through the control panel. I also have it from the Apple website. I will remove it and then install it from the Microsoft Store. Now, finally it's removed. Open the Microsoft Store, search the iTunes. Click on the install button and it will install iTunes. It's installed as well. Open it. It will show you to remove older iTunes files. Click yes to remove those. Here is the newer iTunes. Once the required files are downloaded, attach your device to the computer and turn off the Find My iPhone on your device. It's a necessary step to take before you remove iOS 18 public beta from your device. If you do not do it, it will show you an error. To turn off Find My iPhone, go to the settings, type Find My in the search, tap here, tap on the toggle to turn it off. Put in your Apple ID password when it asks. After that, it will be turned off. Now you are ready to downgrade iOS 18 beta to iOS 17.5.1 using iTunes on a Windows PC. Now, completely backup your device using iTunes. This is a necessary step if you want your data back after the downgrading process. On iTunes, select this computer option. Click on the backup button. You can also select the encryption option before taking a backup. It will backup all the app's login credentials as well. And when you restore the backup, you will not have to log into all the apps again. Once you select the options, click on the backup button and the process to backup iPhone data will start. You can see the progress at the top of iTunes. The backup process could take a little while depending on the amount of data you have on your device. We will restore iOS 18 backup to iOS 17 using iTunes at the end. So keep watching this video till the end. As you can see, the backup is created. Remember the time it was created. You can check that from here. By this time, your device must be connected to your Windows PC. Find My iPhone must be turned off. You must have iTunes installed on your computer from the Microsoft Store, and an IPSW file should be downloaded. If all these are available, then proceed further. Now before I move forward, hit the like and the subscribe button for more upcoming iOS 18 related videos. Open iTunes, hold the shift button, then click the restore iPhone button on iTunes. This will open a new window to select the IPSW file. Select where you downloaded it and the downgrading process to go back to iOS 17.5.1 from iOS 18 public beta will start. Click the restore button on the pop-up once you select the IPSW file. It could take a little while to complete depending on your PC's performance. Make sure you do not disconnect your device during the process by accident or deliberately, or you could end up in a trouble with your device. Click apply on this pop-up. Click on restore here. Once the process is complete, you will see this message on your Windows computer stating that the restore is done. Watch your device, check the iOS version from the settings and confirm if it's downgraded successfully. Also let me know in the comments below. The setup process is done on my device. Let me show you the downgraded iOS version. Here you can see I am on iOS 17.5.1. And the device is completely empty for now. By far, it was just a simple process to downgrade iOS 18 public beta to 17 using iTunes on a Windows PC. The main part is still left where you need to restore the iOS 18 backup to iOS 17. First, disconnect and again connect your device to the computer because sometimes the PC does not recognize it. You will see this screen. Select the setup device as new and click on continue button. Restoring backup on the lower iOS version on Windows is little different as compared to Mac process. The Mac tutorial is in the description below. Now again, as I did earlier, turn off Find My iPhone again. For that, go to the settings, search Find My, tap here. Turn off the toggle to turn off Find My iPhone and put in Apple ID password when it asks. Now you need to change the iOS version in the backup in the info.plist file, and then you can restore iOS 18 backup to iOS 17 using iTunes on a Windows computer. Otherwise, you won't be able to restore it as it is right now. You can try, it will give you an error. Let me just show you that. It won't let you restore and show you a compatibility error. Here you can see. Now click on restore backup button on iTunes and note the time of the last backup you took and want to restore. Once noted, press Windows plus R key, type this command and open this folder. It has taken me directly into the roaming folder. If you are in the app data folder, go into the roaming folder, then into Apple computer, then into mobile sync, then into backup. The folders you see inside of the backup folder are the backups you have taken on your computer using iTunes. If you do not see the current backup folders, you can find them in another location by following another path I am showing you. Again, press Windows plus R command, type this command and open the folder. Then go inside the Apple folder, then mobile sync, and the backup folder. you have to find the backup folder with the time you noted already. Here you can see, I found mine in this location. This can differ for you. Now open the backup folder, scroll down and find the file named info.plist. Right click on it and open it with the text editor or notepad. Once opened, press Ctrl plus F buttons on this notepad. Type product version and hit enter. Now find the line showing the iOS version in number. In this case, find iOS 18.0 under the product version and change the version to 17 and save the file. Now you can restore iOS 18 backup to iOS 17 with iTunes on Windows. Go back to iTunes, click on the Restore Backup button, select the backup in which you just changed the iOS version and click on the Restore. The process to restore iOS 18 backup to 17 with iTunes will start. Now wait for it to be completed. This is how to downgrade iOS 18 to 17 without losing data using iTunes on a Windows computer and restore iOS 18 backup to 17 using iTunes. Please let me know in the comments below if you have any questions.